நாகை சூடமா.
Hi, hello everyone, good morning. Here to discuss about an interesting and important topic, human reproduction. Friends, you know everyone about what is reproduction. Reproduction is the biological process by which new individual organisms, I mean offsprings, are produced from parents. Reproduction is a fundamental feature of all known life. Each individual organisms exist because of reproduction. This is about reproduction. Now we will pass on to human reproduction. Humans are sexually reproducing viviparous and unisexual organism. Here viviparous means they give birth to young ones. Unisexual means here sexes are separate, male individual separate and a female individual is separate. In humans, the reproductive units in sexual reproduction are specialized cells called gametes. That means sperm and ova. These gametes are produced from the primary sex organs called testes and ovary. The primary sex organs are also called gonads. Friends, now we will move on the next topic about reproductive events in human beings. There are certain events sequentially takes place in human reproduction. They are gametogenesis, insemination, fertilization and so on. Now we will discuss one by one. Gametogenesis, it means formation of gametes by spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Insemination, it means transfer of sperms by male into the female reproductive tract. Fertilization, it means fusion of male and female gametes to form a single celled structure called zygote. Cleavage, the single celled structure called zygote undergoes rapid mitotic division and forms into a multicellular structure called blastocyst. The next event in reproduction of human being is implantation. It is nothing but the attachment of blastocysts to the uterine wall. The next one is placentation. Placentation is the formation of placenta, which is the intimate connection between fetus and the uterine wall of the mother for exchange of nutrients. Gastrulation, it is a process by which blastocyst is changed into three germ primary germ layers. Organogenesis, from these three primary germ layers certain tissues organs are formed. This process is called organogenesis. The last event in reproduction of human being is parturition. Parturition is nothing but expulsion of the fetus from the mother. Here expulsion means delivery. Friends, you can observe clearly on the screen the diagrammatic representation of male reproductive system here. See, the male reproductive system consists a pair of testes, accessory ducts, accessory glands and external genitalia. Here the testes are called primary male sex organs. These male reproductive system, everything is located in pelvic region. A pair of testes lying in scrotum. Friends, you know, now you understand that where the testes is occupying, the testes is lying in the scrotum. Friends, do you know where scrotum is occupying? Yes, scrotum is a sac of skin that hangs outside the abdominal cavity to provide a temperature 2 to 3 degrees Celsius lower than the normal body temperature. That's why the scrotum is occupied outside the abdominal cavity. Here it reduces 2 to 3 degrees Celsius lower than the body normal body temperature. It called as thermoregulator for spermatogenesis. Friends, you can see the diagrammatic representation of the anatomical structure of testis here on the screen. See, the testis is a ovoid structure. A pair of testes is placed in the scrotum. The testes is ovoid in structure. It is covered by a fibrous capsule called tunica albuginea. Friends, here you can see the so many compartments are present inside the testes. These compartments are called lobules. These compartments are separated by a wall called septa. Testes are paired male gonads covered by an outermost fibrous capsule, just I told you. That capsule is called tunica albuginea. This testes is divided by septa into many compartments. Each compartment are called lobules. There are about 200 to 250 compartments or lobules. Each lobule contains 2 to 4 highly coiled testicular structure called seminiferous tubule. Inside the seminiferous tubule, there are two types of cells. The one is male germ cells or spermatogonial cells. Another one is Sertoli cells or supporting cells or nerve cells. Here, friends, what is the function of male germ cells? The male germ cells undergoes mitotic division and produce spermatozoa. Friends, what is the function of Sertoli cells here? Why it is called supporting cells? These Sertoli cells nourishes the growing spermatozoans so that they are called nurse cells. These Sertoli cells are elongated pyramidal cells. It nourishes the sperm till maturation. The Sertoli cells also secretes another one hormone called inhibin. This hormone involved in negative feedback control of sperm production. It controls the sperm production. Next, region outside the seminiferous tubules called interstitial spaces. Region outside the seminiferous tubules called interstitial spaces contain small blood vessels. Interstitial cells are leading cells and immunologically competent cells. These interstitial spaces occupies small blood vessels, interstitial cells or leading cells and other immunologically competent cells. The leading cells plays very important role in male reproduction. They synthesize and secrete a male hormone called androgen, otherwise it is called testosterone. Why it is called testosterone? This hormone is secreted from the testes, so it is called testosterone. This testosterone initiates the process of spermatogenesis. Next, let us discuss about the accessory ducts of male reproductive system. The accessory ducts of male reproductive system are rete testis, vas efferentia, epididymis, vas deferens. These are the accessory ducts of male reproductive system. Friends, here we can observe that the conduction of sperms, pathway of sperms through accessory ducts. Sperms enters from seminiferous tubules to rete testis, from rete testis to vas efferentia, vas efferentia to epididymis, epididymis to vas deferens, from where it passed to the common ejaculatory duct, from where it passed to urethra, from where it passed outside through urethral meatus. Friends, you listen here that epididymis lies between the vas efferentia and vas deferens. See, vas deferens lies between epididymis and a common ejaculatory duct. Here, the urethra, you can observe the diagram, urethra. urethra lies below the vas deferens, ejaculatory duct. Here it receives the ducts of prostate and Cowper's gland and pass through the penis. Friends, we will see in detail about the accessory ducts. First, the retae testis. It is a tubular network on the posterior side of the testis. Urethra, it is a terminal portion of the male reproductive system and is used to convey both urine and semen at different times. Epididymis, it is very important organ in male reproductive system. It is a single highly coiled tube that temporarily stores the spermatozoa and they undergo physiological maturation. If epididymis is not present in the male reproductive system, the sperms will not have physiological, will not attain physiological maturation. Accessory glands. Accessory glands consist of a pair of seminal vesicles, a prostate gland, a pair of Cowper's or bulbourethral glands. Friends, you must listen here. In accessory glands, seminal vesicles and Cowper's or bulbourethral glands are paired glands. Prostate is a single gland. In accessory glands, prostate is a single gland. Rest of the two are paired glands. These glands secretes, these secretion collectively called seminal plasma. Seminal plasma consists rich in fructose, calcium and enzymes. Friends, you know what is semen? Semen is nothing but seminal plasma and sperm together called semen. Friends, now we will see the functions of seminal plasma. Seminal plasma helps for transporting sperms. It supplies nutrients to sperms. It provides alkalinity to counteract acidity of uterus. Secretions of Cowper's glands lubricate the penis. The secretion of epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicle and prostate help for maturation and motility of sperms. Friends, the last topic in male reproductive system is external genitalia, or the external genitalia in male reproductive system is penis. You can observe the diagrammatic representation on the screen that penis, it is covered by two types of tissues called corpus cavernosum, corpus spongiosum. These are the tissues covered the penis. The tip of the penis is called foreskin, is called glands. These glands is covered by a skin called foreskin or prepuce. Friends, this is about the detailed view of male reproductive system. Next, we will pass on to the female reproductive system. The female reproductive system consists of paired ovaries, accessory ducts, external genitalia. Accessory ducts are oviducts, uterus and vagina. Here, there is a single uterus, single vagina and a paired oviducts or fallopian tube. External genitalia are mons pubis, vestibule, hymen and clitoris. Now we will see about the ovaries, the structure of ovaries, where it is placed, etc. Friends, you can observe the structure of ovaries on the screen. See, it is located on both sides of the lower abdomen and connected to the pelvic wall and uterus by ligaments. These ligaments is called mesovarium. So, ovaries are the primary sex organs which produce ova. Ova is a female gamete this ova in turn secretes certain ovarian hormones, steroid ovarian hormones called estrogen and progesterone. Each ovary is covered by a thin epithelium which encloses the ovarian stroma. You can see the structure of ovary. The ovary is covered by ovarian stroma. The stroma has outer cortex and inner medulla. See, the outer cortex is filled with follicle cells, and medulla is filled with blood vessels, connective tissues, lymphatic vessels, and nerve fibers. The medulla of the ovary contains group of ovarian cells or Graafian follicles. Each follicles carries a centrally placed ovum. Next, in the female reproductive system, we will see the accessory ducts or duct system. The duct system consists two oviducts or fallopian tubes, uterus or womb, and a vagina. You can observe the diagram on the screen about oviducts, uterus, and vagina. We will see one by one about the female accessory ducts. First, oviducts. It is also called fallopian tubes. See the diagram on the screen. You can see the structure of the oviduct. It has three parts: impendibulum, ambula, and isthmus. Its length is 10 to 12 centimeter. The structure on the peripheral area of the ovary is called infundibulum. It is funnel shaped structure. In front, it has many finger like structure called fimbriae. This fimbriae helps to collect the ovum. The wider part of the oviduct is called ambula, and the narrow part of the oviduct is called isthmus, which joins the uterus. The inner lining of the oviduct is lined by ciliated epithelium. It helps to drive the ovum towards the uterus. Next, uterus. The below given diagram says clearly about the structure of uterus. Uterus is otherwise called womb. It is inverted pear shape. It is supported by ligaments attached to the pelvic wall. Uterus has three parts. One is fundus. It is the upper part, and body, it is the middle part, and cervix, the terminal part. The cervix open to vagina. The uterine wall has three layers. They are: the outer thin layer is called perimetrium, middle thick smooth muscle layer is called myometrium, and inner glandular and vascular layer is called endometrium. There are three layers are present in the uterus. Next one is vagina. It opens to exterior between urethra and anus. It is very important that vagina opens exterior between urethra and anus. This you can see the diagram on the screen, that vagina, see the vagina is placed between the anus. Anus is present below the rectum. See, rectum, below the rectum is anus, and in the right side is urethra. Between that, vagina is placed. The lumen of vagina, that is inner lining of vagina, is lined by a glycogen rich mucous membrane consisting of sensitive papillae and Bartholin's gland. Very important. That Bartholin glands is very important. It lies in the vagina. It secretes some mucus substance which lubricates the vagina during sexual course. The last part of the human female reproductive system is external genitalia or vulva. It consists of mons pubis, vestibule, hymen and clitoris. Mons pubis, you can observe the diagram on the screen. Mons pubis is a fatty tissue covered by pubic hair. Vestibule is a median channel, that means it lies in the middle. It has two part, major, labia majora and labia minora. Labia majora is a large, fleshy, fatty and hairy outer fold surrounds vaginal opening. Labia minora is small, thin and hairless inner folding. Inner folding is a labia minora. Next one is hymen. It is also called maiden head, a membrane which partially covers the vaginal opening and it is often torn during the first coitus. However, the hymen may also be broken by a sudden fall or jolt, insertion of a vaginal tampon, active participation in sport item, etc. In some women, hymen persists even after coitus. So, the hymen is not a reliable indicator of virginity. The last one is clitoris. It is a highly sensitive organ lying just in front of the urethral opening. In female, the clitoris is a highly sensitive organ. In male, the penis is a highly sensitive organ. The last one is mammary gland or breast. Mammary glands consist glandular tissue or pad. See friends, you can see the screen. The yellow color part is called a glandular tissue. This glandular tissue of each breast has 50 to 20 mammary lobes. Each lobes contains clusters of cells called a mammary alveoli. In the yellow color picture, each cell is called a mammary alveoli. These alveoli secretes milk and this milk is stored in the lumen of alveoli. Lumen means cavity of alveoli. Alveoli open into mammary tubules. Mammary tubules join to form mammary duct. The mammary duct join to form a wider part called a mammary ambula, which is connected lactiferous duct through which milk is sucked out. You can see the diagram or flow chart of milk from origin to the ejected out. See, mammary alveoli secretes milk. It passes it to the mammary tubule. From mammary tubule, it passes to the mammary duct. From where it passes to the mammary ambula, from where it ejects out through lactiferous duct. That's all about the female reproductive system. Friends, now we will move on to check about your grasping power, that is question time. The first question is, select the odd one from the following. See, there are four words is given here, that is you must select which one is odd one, which one is not related. A, prostate gland. B, Cowper's glands. C, seminal vesicles. D, epididymis. Friends, you can answer this question very easily if you know about the male reproductive system, that means about the primary sex organs, accessory ducts and accessory glands. In this question, the first three, that means prostate glands, Cowper's gland and seminal vesicles, are accessory male reproductive glands. Epididymis is a accessory male reproductive duct. I already told you that epididymis is the storehouse of the sperm. The next question is, which is false statement? See friends, here there are four statements are given. You must identify which is a false statement. The first statement is, testes are the primary sex organs of male. Second is Sertoli cells gives nourishment to developing sperms. Leydig cells produce androgen hormone. Rete testis temporarily stores sperms. Here in this, the first three statements are correct. The fourth statement, rete testis is a testicular structure which arises from the testis. It is not stores the sperms temporarily. It passes the sperms to the vasa efferentia. So that is the function of rete testis. So the wrong statement is D statement. Rete testis temporarily stores sperm. The statement should come like this. That means epididymis stores temporarily the sperms. The next question is seminal plasma in humans rich in. See the seminal plasma. First of all, what is seminal plasma? Seminal plasma is secreted by male reproductive glands, that is seminal glands, prostate glands and bulbourethral gland. Here fructose and calcium but has no enzymes, glucose and certain enzymes but has no calcium, fructose and certain enzymes but poor in calcium, fructose, calcium and certain enzymes. See, seminal plasma consists of fructose, calcium and certain enzymes. Here is fructose only provides energy to the sperm. Calcium is a mineral which also helps for the movement of the sperms, etc. The next question is Sertoli cells are found in. So it is a very easy question that Sertoli cells are found in the seminiferous tubules and nourishes the germ cells. So it is also called supporting cells or nurse cells. Here the other three are statements are ovaries and secrete progesterone. Ovaries and secrete progesterone. Sertoli cells is not present in the ovaries. Sertoli cells is not present in the adrenal cortex. Sertoli cells are not present in the pancreas. The next question is vasa efferentia are the ductulus leading from it leading from. See, vasa efferentia or ductulus leading from rete testis to vas deferens via epididymis. So B is the correct answer. Vasa efferentia or the ductulus leading from rete testis to vas deferens via epididymis. The next question is the Leydig cells as found in the human body are the secretory source of. See friends, I already told you that interstitial spaces consist of Leydig cells and some immunologically competent cells. Here the Leydig cells secretes a male sex organ called androgen or otherwise called testosterone. See here the other options given here, no? A, progesterone. Progesterone is a female sex organ produced by ova, intestinal mucus, it is produced by intestines, and glucagon, it is produced by B, alpha cells of the pancreas. The next question is, if for some reason vasa efferentia in the human reproduction system get blocked, the gametes will not be transported from. See friends, listen carefully the question. Which part of the human male reproductive duct is cut off? Vasa efferentia. You must know where vasa efferentia is placed. It is placed between the rete testis and epididymis. If it is cut off or blocked, the gametes will not be transported from epididymis to vas deferens, because next to the vasa efferentia what duct is present? Epididymis. Next to epididymis what duct is present? Vas deferens. So B is the correct answer. The next question, in human the unpaired male reproductive structure is. See, I already told you while teaching that the human male reproductive gland are three. They are seminal gland, this is a paired gland, prostate gland, this is a single gland, Cowper's or bulbourethral gland, this is also a paired gland. So the correct answer, unpaired male reproductive structure, is prostate gland. The next question is, the mature sperm are stored in, it is very easy question, you can say the answer directly. The mature sperm are stored in epididymis, yes, correct, epididymis. Epididymis is the storehouse of sperm. The next question is, the glandular accessory organ which produces the largest proportion of semen is, see friends, you must know one thing, that 70% of the semen is produced from the seminal vesicles. There are three reproductive accessory gland, male accessory glands in male. They are paired seminal glands, paired bulbourethral gland, single prostate gland. Among them, seminal vesicle secretes 70% of the semen. So the correct answer is seminal vesicle. The male homology of the female clitoris is, see friends, first of all you must clear what is homologous organ. Homologous organ means the structure is different, the function is same. Structure is different, they are performing a similar function, that is called a homologous organ. Here what question is given? The male homology of the female clitoris is, the male homology of the female clitoris is penis. Why? In female, clitoris is a highly sensitive organ. In male, penis is a highly sensitive organ. The next question is, the androgen binding protein ABP produced by A, leading cells, B, hypothalamus, C, Sertoli cells, D, pituitary glands. See friends, I already told you about Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells are present in the seminiferous tubules in between the sperm mother cells. The Sertoli cells, under the influence of FSH and LH, they produce androgen binding protein. So this is the correct answer. C is the correct answer. Leading cells will not be the answer because leading cells secretes androgen. Hypothalamus will not be the answer because it stimulates pituitary gland. Pituitary gland will not be the answer because it secretes so many hormones. The part of fallopian tube closest to ovaries. Friends, to answer this question, you must clearly know about the structure of fallopian tube. See, the fallopian tube has three structure, the anterior funnel shaped structure called infundibulum, the wider part is called ambula, and the narrow part is called isthmus, which is connected with the uterus. So the question is what here? The part of fallopian tube closest to ovary is the narrower part of fallopian tube called isthmus. Next, what is ovulation? Or ovulation is, it is very easy question. Ovulation is release of ovum from the ovary. See here, there are four options is given here: formation of ovum in the ovary, release of ovarian hormones, formation of ovarian follicles, release of ovum from the ovary. See, for A, formation of ovum in the ovary is called oogenesis. B, release of ovarian hormones. Ovary secretes two types of hormones, estrogen and progesterone. Next, formation of ovarian follicles. Follicles are formed due to the influence of follicle stimulating hormones. So the correct answer of this question is release of ovum from ovary. The next question is, the muscular layer of the uterus is, see, when I teaching, I already told you that the uterus is made up of three types of layers. They are perimetrium, myometrium and endometrium. Perimetrium is a outer thin membrane, myometrium is a middle thick muscular layer, endometrium is a inner glandular and vascular layer. Here what question is asking? Muscular layer is a myometrium. Why, what is the significance of muscular layer here? The muscular layer contracts during parturition. So the fetus will delivered easily. Which of the following organs is highly sensitive? I already told you that clitoris in female is the highly sensitive organ. That is a very easy question, you can answer it directly. The next question is, which is not a part of accessory ducts of female reproductive system? See, we must know clearly about what are the accessory ducts of female reproductive system, what are the accessory glands of female reproductive system, what are external genitalia of female reproductive system, what are primary sex organs of female reproductive system. Here, ducts, here they are asking what? Ducts. The accessory ducts are, I already told you that fallopian tube, uterus and vagina. Here, the correct answer is vagina. What are not a part of? So, yeah, okay, you must listen here. It is a negative question. Not a part of. But not a part of means what? Graafian follicle. Graafian follicle is the structure of primary sex organ. The next question is, several mammary duct joined to form. In the slide, I have given one flow chart. You know, the mammary ducts, all the ducts join to form ambula. See, you can answer easily because ambula is a wider part. Wherever you read read ambula, ambula is a wider part. So the all the tubules join to the ambula. So the correct answer is mammary ambula. The next question is, in human female, the blastocyst, it forms placenta even before implantation? No, never. Gets implanted into uterus 3 days after ovulation? No. Gets nutrition from uterine endometrial secretion only after implantation? No. Gets implanted in endometrium by the trophoblast cell. See, friends, the blastocyst, after several mitotic divisions, it forms the outer layer called troposoblast and the inner cell mass. The troposoblast gets implanted in endometrium. So, this is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. The next question is, delivery of developed fetus is scientifically called. So, previously, the beginning, I told you that the scientific term of delivery of fetus is called a parturition. See here, there are four words are given: parturition, oviposition, abortion, ovulation. See friends, abortion means delivery of embryo or fetus before maturation, before development. This is called abortion. Delivery of fetus under developed condition are called abortion. Ovulation means release of ovum from the graafian follicle cells is called ovulation. It attains by the influence of LH hormones. The next question is, Bartholin's gland is found in. It is very easy question. Bartholin gland is related with the female reproductive system. It lies in the vagina. It lies in the vagina. So, the correct answer is vagina, not liver, not in penis, not in stomach. The next question is, clitoris in female mammal is, clitoris is a highly sensitive organ. It is the homologous to penis to male, because in male, penis is the highly sensitive organ. Next, the temperature of scrotum as compared to abdominal cavity is less by. The beginning itself, I told you that the scrotum maintains 2 to 3 degree less temperature than the normal body temperature to production of viable sperms. So that the correct answer is 2 degree Celsius, that is B answer. The next question, vas deferens is cut for. See, the vas, this is the surgical cut. It is cut for mere sterilization. If we cut and tied means the sperms will not pass to the urethra. The next question is, secretion of which gland has high percentage of fructose? See friends, I already told you the seminal fluid, 70% of the seminal fluid is secreted from seminal vesicle. So the high percentage of fructose is secreted by seminal vesicle. So seminal vesicle is the correct answer. In mammals, failure of testes to descend into the scrotum. See, in mammals, testes are lies in the scrotum. Scrotum lies in the extra abdominal cavity. Here, what question is given here? In mammals, failure of testes to descend into the scrotum is known as 1. Pedogenesis, B. Gametogenesis, C. Cryptorchidism, D. Impotency. See, friends, pedogenesis is a type of parthenogenesis. That means the unfertilized egg develops into larva. It is called pedogenesis. Gametogenesis, it is very easy, that formation of gametes, sperm and ova. Cryptorchidism is the failure of testes to descend into the scrotum. Impotency means inability to have production of sperms and sexual erection. Next, the functional unit of testes of man is, it is very easy, the functional unit is called seminiferous tubules. See, there are so many tubules are given here, you should not have confused. Uriniferous tubules, which are present in the kidney, Malpighian tubules, which are also present in the kidney, Acini, which is present in the thyroid gland. The lobules of the thyroid gland is called Acini. So the correct answer is seminiferous tubules. Next, seminiferous tubules are composed of, I already told you, so that the seminiferous tubules are composed of, it is made up of germinal epithelial cells. Germinal epithelial cells are sperm mother cells. So D is the correct answer. Germinal epithelial cells are sperm mother cells is the correct answer. The next question. In between spermatogonia are found. See, it is also very easy. In seminiferous tubules, in between the spermatogonia, Sertoli cells are present. Sertoli cells are present. So B is the correct answer. Seminal vesicle is present at the junction of, where the seminal vesicle is present? Seminal vesicle is a paired organ, paired male reproductive accessory gland. Where it is present? It is present between prostate and urethra, or prostate and vas deferens, or prostate and Cowper's gland, or vas deferens and urethra. It lies between the prostate and vas deferens. So B is the correct answer. Next, the very easy question. Seminiferous tubules occur in, where it occurs, whether it is in uterus or scrotum or ovary or testis. Where it occurs? It occurs in the testis. It is very easy question. Next, the seminal fluid as sperms and secretions of, I already told you that seminal fluid is secreted from the male accessory reproductive glands. The male accessory reproductive glands are what? 1. A paired seminal vesicle, a single prostate gland, and a paired Cowper's or bulbourethral gland. So the B is the correct answer. A will not be the correct answer because here Bartholin gland is given. Bartholin glands are present in the female reproductive organs. And the C will not be the answer. Why? Because here ureter is given. Ureter is the male reproductive duct. C will not be the correct answer. Why? Because follicle cells are given. Follicle cells will not produce seminal fluids because it is present in the ovaries. The next question, if the epididymis is not present, then what will happen? Friends, I already told you about the epididymis. Epididymis is an organ for storage of sperms, which stores sperms, and it also helps for attaining physiological maturation. It also nourishes the sperms. So the sperm life cycle is short. It will not happen. Yearly maturation, it also will not happen. Functional maturation is yearly, not happen. If not, what will happen? Sperm will be incapable of fertilization because it will not attain physiological maturation. So the correct answer is sperm will be incapable of fertilization. Which one is primary sex organ? It is very easy. Primary sex organ in male is testes and in female is ovary. So here what is given? Testes is given. You can directly answer the question. Testes is the primary sex organ. The next question. Vagina of female reproductive system is vagina of female reproductive system is primary sex organ, B essential sex organ, C secondary sex organ, D none. The vagina of female reproductive system is secondary sex organ. Primary sex organ of female reproductive system is ovaries. The next question. Lower narrow end of uterus is called, narrow end is called cervix. It connects cervix connected with vagina through a cervical canal. So the correct answer is cervix. The next question, endometrium is lining of what? Uterus. Endometrium is a lining of uterus, not testis, not urinary bladder, not ureter. Expanded proximal part of oviduct. See, expanded proximal part. Proximal part means front part of oviduct in female. C ureter, B fallopian tube, C fimbriated funnel, D vestibule. The correct answer is fimbriated funnel. It is the expanded proximal part which very close the periphery of the ovary. The next question, which is not a secondary sex organ? See, vagina, penis, prostate, mammary gland. See, in the given, vagina is the secondary sex organ, penis, which is not a secondary sex organ. See, mammary gland is not a secondary sex organ. The next, Cowper's glands are found in, where the Cowper's gland found? In male mammals, or female birds, or male amphibians, or female amphibians. It is found in the male mammals. The next question. A female gland corresponding to prostate of male is, female gland corresponding to prostate of male is. See, in what are the options given here? Bartholin's gland, B bulbourethral gland, C clitoris, D Skene's paraurethral gland. See, first of all, we must know what is the function of prostate in males. See, the prostate gland lubricates the penis. For what the corresponding function of the given option is does here? Bartholin's gland. Bartholin glands lubricates the vagina during intercourse. The next but last question here, assertion reason question. Here one assertion is given and for that reason is also given. You must say the answer if A and R are true, R is the correct explanation of A. If A and R are true, R is not correct explanation of A true or false. So you may have well versed about this question. Here what assertion is given? In human male, testes are extra abdominal and lie in scrotal sacs. Reason: scrotum acts as a thermoregulator and keeps temperature lower by 2 degrees Celsius for normal sperm production. See, you listen the assertion. In human male, testes lies in the abdominal and in the scrotal sacs. That is correct. Why is testes lies in the scrotal sacs? Because testes act as a thermoregulator to keep the temperature below the normal body temperature. So that here A and R are true, R is the correct explanation of A. Friends, till now we have discussed so many questions. From these questions you may understand the content of human reproduction, particularly the male and female reproductive system. Friends, you also can create so many questions and answer for them, so that you will be well versed in the content. you please do it. Thank you very much. Bye. See you again.
இந்நிகழ்ச்சியை பற்றிய தங்களின் மேலான கருத்துக்களை கீழ்கண்ட முகவரிக்கு கடிதம் மூலமாகவோ மின்னஞ்சல் மூலமாகவோ குறுஞ்செய்தி மூலமாகவோ தெரியப்படுத்தலாம். அனுப்ப வேண்டிய முகவரி சிறப்பு அலுவலர் கல்வி தொலைக்காட்சி 8ஆம் தளம் அண்ணா நூற்றாண்டு நூலகம் காந்தி மண்டப சாலை கோட்டூர்புரம் சென்னை 685 தொலைபேசி எண் 7824 0505000